Hello friends, welcome to video series on general science. In general science, the first topic I'll be explaining is biology. In this video, we'll see about the cell. Cell is the fundamental unit of life, and there are mainly two kinds of cells. One is animal cell, other one is plant cell. And these individual organelles or the cell organelles are the ones which are responsible for various specific functions which are performed by both plant cell as well as animal cell. They are in their position due to a jelly-like substance called as cytoplasm, which holds all the cell organelles in place. And the cytoplasm is covered by plasma membrane. There are very minute differences between plant cell and animal cell. One is the presence of cell wall, which we can see in only plant cells. And the other one is plastids or chloroplast, which are present only in plant cells. Whereas vacuoles are of much larger size in plant cells, whereas the size of the vacuole in animal cell is so tiny. Except these, there are many similarities, like the presence of other cell organelles like lysosome, ribosome, or mitochondria, endoplasmic reticulum, cytoplasm, nucleus, and then Golgi apparatus. So all these cell organelles are common to both plant cell as well as animal cell. We'll see in detail the functionality of each of these organelles. And one thing is common, that each of these organelles have the same functionality whether they are part of plant cell or animal cell. The first organelle is cell membrane. Cell membrane is a porous membrane which is important in transportation of or exchange of various substances between cells as well as cells and the environment. For example, the exchange of gases like oxygen and carbon dioxide happens mainly through plasma membrane, and this process is called diffusion. And also there is exchange of water between various cells as well as cells and the environment, and this is called as osmosis. So osmosis is nothing but diffusion with respect to liquids. Usually diffusion or osmosis happens between a medium of high concentration to a medium of low concentration. A medium of high concentration is called as a hypertonic solution, whereas a medium of low concentration is called as hypotonic solution. So if there is excess amount of oxygen in the outer environment and there is less amount of oxygen in the inner environment of the cell, in such a case the oxygen will be diffused through this plasma membrane towards the cell's interior. So this is one such example of diffusion. So the exchange of gases mainly during cellular respiration happens due to diffusion, and all the exchange of material, whether it is liquid, solid or gas, happens only due to this process of diffusion. This is one example which happens in our lungs, that is the exchange of gases between alveoli mainly happens due to diffusion. So this is an important concept. Osmosis, we can see the modern water purifiers usually use this technique to filter water, that is to separate very tiny microorganisms or very small substances in water. And one more important property of plasma membrane is endocytosis. Endocytosis is mainly seen in amoeba. Amoeba is a unicellular organism which is the tiniest in the world, tiniest among organisms. So amoeba uses the flexible nature of plasma membrane, which is made by proteins and lipids, for their best use in capturing food. So they can deform the shape of the cell, and they are able to engulf various food substances which are available in the environment. So endocytosis is an important phenomenon when it comes to amoeba and their survival. And the plasma membrane is so thin that it can be observed through only electron microscope, which is not visible to particularly sensitive microscopes. In particular, there should be an electron microscope, whereas other cell organelles, being comparatively larger, are visible with certain kinds of sensitive microscopes. And cell membrane is different for plant cells and the cells of bacteria and algae, which are called as prokaryotic cells. Prokaryotic cells have less developed plasma membrane. We'll see that. And the most important part of plant cells is cell wall, which is absent in animal cells. And cell wall is composed of cellulose. Cellulose is an important carbohydrate, or you can say that hydrocarbon like substances, which is mainly made up of hydrogen and carbon. The most important property of cellulose is it can be digested only by animals and not by humans. That is why most of the animal food contains the food of herbivores mainly contains cellulose, whereas humans cannot digest this. So humans don't eat any substance which has great amount of cellulose it is useless to human body, except that it helps in transportation of fecus in large intestine. Other than that, there is no other useful nature of cellulose in human body. And this is present within the outside the plasma membrane, that is, cell wall is outer covering beyond the plasma membrane. And as this is present only in plant cells, we saw that plasma membrane is the outer layer for animal cells. And the most important function is it provides structural strength. This is very important, as plants are immobile and they are rigid at a place. The structural stability plays a very important part. And the cell wall protects from plasmolysis. Plasmolysis is nothing but exchange of huge amount of a substance between the plant, that is the cell layer, and the outer environment. If there is a layer, if there is outer environment which is completely hypotonic, and the cell wall or the cell is hypotonic, in such a case there is huge amount of flow from outside the cell towards interior. As a result, the cell swells up. And if there was no cell membrane or the cell wall, it would simply burst because of intense amount of pressure. But due to presence of cell wall, it can still sustain huge amount of pressures and it stays in position. So cell wall is important in preventing the bursting of cell due to plasmolysis. The very important organelle of cell is nucleus. Nucleus is the one which is called as control center of the cell. Like, just like human nervous system, nucleus plays a very important role in controlling the functionalities of cell. The most important part is it consists of chromosomes. Chromosomes are nothing but genetic material which are important in transferring traits from one organism to other, or I can say from parent to offspring. The nucleus, just like the plasma membrane, has a nuclear membrane which is also porous, and this facilitates the transportation of various substances between the nucleus and the other parts of the cell. Nucleus along with cytoplasm is called as protoplasm, and the chromosomes are the ones which are present within the interior of nucleus, and the nucleolus is a circular spherical region within the nucleus. Chromosomes are observed only during cell division. During other times, chromosomes are present in the form of chromatin material. We can see these are the layers, thread layers, which are present in the form of threads, are called as chromatin. And chromosomes are visible only during cell division. Chromosomes have DNA. DNA is nothing but deoxyribonucleic acid. So it is a protein. And DNA carries all the information necessary for constructing and organizing cells. So when this new cell is born, the arrangement of all the cell organelles and their respective functions are due to the information carried by DNA. And DNA contains small strands of genes, and these genes are important in transferring traits from the parent to the individual. So genes are the major genetic material which are essential in transferring characteristics from parents to offsprings. And based on the presence of nuclear membrane, cells are differentiated into prokaryotic cells and eukaryotic cells. Prokaryotic cells are the ones which don't have a distinguishable nuclear membrane. As a result, the nucleus coincides with the rest of the plant cell body, that is cytoplasm. So it doesn't have a distinguished nucleus, which is, hence the nucleus of such prokaryotic cells is called as nucleoid. So don't get confused with nucleolus. Nucleolus is a spherical part within the nucleus, whereas nucleoid is a nucleus which doesn't have a distinguishable nuclear membrane. One more important feature of prokaryotic cells is that it doesn't have cell organelles which are very distinguishable, highly distinguishable from cytoplasm. So they don't have proper membranes. So all this seems to be messed up within a cytoplasm. So the functionalities also vary. The functionalities is not quite distinctive as in the other plants, other cells. Here, the usual functions of various types are performed mainly by cytoplasm and very weakly developed cell organelles. So this is prokaryotic cell. The eukaryotic cells are exact opposite. The example for prokaryotic cells are bacteria and algae. Except bacteria and algae, all other higher organisms fall under eukaryotic cells. So eukaryotic cells have a very well distinguished nuclear membrane. They have very well distinguished cell organelles, and also all major cell organelles have membranes. So we have seen about nucleoid. Nucleoid is nothing but the nucleus without proper membrane. Coming to chromosomes, we know that human cells have 23 pairs of chromosomes, of which 22 pairs are called as autosomes, which are common for both males and females, whereas the 23rd pair has two chromosomes, which are called as sex chromosomes. They are important in determining the sex of a person. For example, if the chromosomes are X and Y type, in such a case, the sex will be male. And if the chromosomes are X and X, then it will be a female. So this is one of these chromosome is given, comes from the father, and the other one comes from mother. So they are the chromosomes which are obtained from each of the parents, and they are important in determining the sex of the person. And vacuole is also very important part of plants. In animals, it is very tiny. The main function of vacuole is to store substances which are manufactured by various cell organelles, like amino acids, sugars, and various organic acids, proteins, carbohydrates, whatever it is manufactured in the cell. The excess amount of the substance is stored in vacuoles. So vacuoles can be compared to a FCI godown, where things will be stored for a long time till they are necessary for consumption. And the amoeba makes the best use of vacuole, because amoeba is a highly less developed organism. It doesn't have proper cell organelles. Vacuole plays an important role in both digesting the food as well as expelling the food. So in amoeba, vacuole is the most important cell organelle. The next one is endoplasmic reticulum. Endoplasmic reticulum has mainly two functions. One is the production of protein, and the other one is production of fat. And it also helps in preparing these both fat and proteins to supply to the rest of the cell body. So you can compare this to a railway station. We'll see next about Golgi apparatus, which helps in transportation of all these fats and proteins. So we can see there are two kinds of endoplasmic reticulum. One is rough endoplasmic, other one is smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Rough endoplasmic reticulum has ribosomes. They are very important in the synthesis of proteins. Very important point. And endoplasmic reticulum helps in transportation of these synthesized proteins. Coming to smooth endoplasmic reticulum, it manufactures fat molecules or lipids. So they are important in manufacture of fats. So both rough and smooth together, they manufacture proteins and molecules, that is fat molecules, which are helpful in membrane biogenesis. Membrane biogenesis is nothing but creation of a membrane. And then proteins and lipids, we can see proteins manufactured by ribosomes and lipids by smooth endoplasmic reticulum are important as they function as enzymes and hormones. Remember this, we'll be seeing about hormones and enzymes in future videos. And then certain liver cells of various vertebrates, higher organisms, are helpful in detoxifying many poisons and drugs due to the presence of smooth endoplasmic reticulum, which plays a major role in detoxifying many poisons and drugs. So these are the functions of endoplasmic reticulum. Coming to Golgi complex, we have seen that most of these substances are synthesized by endoplasmic reticulum. Endoplasmic reticulum also has a very good network of transportation. But the major transportation services are provided by Golgi complex. So Golgi complex does mainly three jobs. One is the packing, storage of various substances prepared by cell organelles. And then it is the main thing that transports all these substances. And the third important one is the preparation of lysosomes. Lysosomes are nothing but, you can compare them to pigs. They just do a cleaning process. They eat up all the waste and they clean all the mess that is created within the cell. We'll see much more detail about lysosomes in the next slide. Now let us see. Golgi complex are nothing but membrane bound vesicles. They are simply long tubular bags. And they are connected to endoplasmic reticulum. We have seen how endoplasmic reticulum helps in transportation. So this is how they facilitate transportation of various proteins, carbohydrates, etc. to all parts of the cell. And the major function is packaging and then storing these various components. That is the main function of Golgi complex. And then what it does is it transports all this material. Along with that, it converts complex sugars from simple sugars. That is, it prepares complex sugars from simple sugars. So these are the other functions. But lysosome is the most important one. If you see lysosome, lysosome is nothing but the waste disposal system. Waste disposal system is comes into action when a cell is dead or when there is a bacteria or a foreign material which needs to be expelled from the cell. In such a case, lysosome will act as play three different roles. One is the role of a soldier. It keeps on killing the enemies. And the other role is the role of a suicide bomber. Hence it is called a suicide bag because when there is cell division and if the cell division doesn't occur in a proper manner, in such a case the cell will be a defaulty one and such a cell is harmful to the body. As a result, the lysosome releases certain enzymes which will burst the cell. Hence they are called as suicide bags. Other than this, the other function is the function performed by a pig. What it does, it simply cleans up mess, that is, it consumes all this waste material which is present within the cell, like the dead cells, dead bacteria, etc. And coming to mitochondria is very important part because it is the powerhouse of the cell. It provides with all the power required for the various processes within the cell. So we need power for transportation, we need power for packaging, storing, etc., everything. So this acts like a power plant. And mitochondria transmits this power in the form of ATP, that is adenosine triphosphate. Hence, ATP can be compared to electricity, which is transmitted along cables. So ATP is the electricity of cell. Hence, it is called as energy currency of the cell. And mitochondria has two membrane coverings because it is very sophisticated cell organelle. And also they have their own DNA and ribosomes. This is a very important concept. Mitochondria has its own DNA and ribosomes. We have seen that ribosomes are helpful in protein synthesis. So DNA can synthesize its own proteins as well as it has its own DNA. So it has its peculiar characteristics and it is able to make some of their own proteins because of presence of ribosomes. And coming to the last concept, which is plastids. Plastids are present only in plant cells. We know that plastids are responsible for the green color of leaves because they contain a pigment called as chlorophyll. And these plastids which have chlorophyll as their main pigment, they are called as chloroplasts. And chloroplasts are important in photosynthesis. And certain plant cells have pigments which are other colors. For example, in this plant we can see this part is red in color, other part is green. This is because the green color is because a majority of the plastids have chloroplasts or chlorophyll in them as the main pigment, whereas the red color is because of presence of various other color pigments in higher numbers. That is, if chlorophyll is the highest pigment in the plastids, in such a case the leaf will look green. In the other case where the chlorophyll is outnumbered by various other pigments, in such a case the plant leaf will look with other colors, that is red or green. But the most common feature is photosynthesis. So photosynthesis is performed by both the red region as well as the green region. So it is independent of color. As long as there is chlorophyll, the photosynthesis takes place. And chlorophyll is present in both the regions. But the only thing in red region is that it is outnumbered by other pigments. So again, plastids are divided into chromoplasts and leucoplasts. Leucoplasts are white or colorless plastids, whereas chromoplasts are colored plastids. And leucoplasts are important in storage of oils and proteins. So they also play a very important part in storing, like we have seen the FCI, that is the other organelle like vacuole. And plastids are similar to mitochondria in a way that they have their own DNA and also they have their own DNA, the first important point. And then they have ribosomes because of which they can synthesize proteins. So a quick recap of all the concepts. We have seen the first important organelle is cell membrane. Cell membrane is a porous border like India-Nepal border, which facilitates the transportation or exchange of various materials. And then the next one is cell wall. Cell wall which is present only in plants and it provides structural strength. And the next one is nucleus. Nucleus is a very important part of the cell. It acts as a nervous system, as also it helps in division, cell division, which can be compared to human reproduction. And then the next one is vacuole, which plays the role of an FCI, that is a godown. So it stores all the excess material which is available after the cell organelles synthesize various materials. And then we have endoplasmic reticulum, which has ribosomes, that is rough endoplasmic have ribosomes, which manufacture proteins. And the smooth one manufactures fats. So endoplasmic reticulum facilitates the transportation of all these substances, that is both fats and proteins. And the Golgi complex plays the major role in storage and packaging of all these substances manufactured by endoplasmic reticulum, and they are transported to various regions by Golgi complex. And Golgi complex prepare one important component called as lysosome. Lysosome plays three important roles. One, it plays the role of a soldier, that is, it kills all the fallen unnecessary particles. And then it plays the role of a suicide bomber, which is called, hence it is called a suicide bag of the cell, because it destroys improper cells. And then it plays the role of a pig, which simply cleans up all the mess, that is, it digests or engulfs all the mess in the cell. And then we have mitochondria, which is called the powerhouse of the cell. And the adenosine triphosphate is used to transfer this power to various regions of the cell. And then we have plastids, in which the color of the presence of chlorophyll determines the color of the leaf and also the amount of photosynthesis. So this is the end of the video. Thanks for watching, and if you like my video, please like, share and give your feedback, and also subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.